Hey everyone, I'm Ginger Walker and I'm with
Jeremy Gray. How's it going?
And I'm going to be on the radio every first Friday at B101.5 for the Ask the Realtor segment. How can they send in their questions?
540-899-1015. You can call or you can text, so hit us up.
Awesome. Look forward to hearing you or seeing you on the radio.
Thanks for hanging out this morning. It's Jeremy Gray's show. We've got Ginger Walker in the house with the giveback team of Coldwell Banker Elite, along with Lauren. Good morning. How are you?
Good morning, sunshine.
Oh, sunshine. I get sunshine this morning, huh? I can deal with that. That's what's up. You having a good week so far?
Absolutely.
Good deal.
My son's birthday was yesterday, so celebrated that, had a great time.
Happy birthday to him. I hear he wants to jump out of a plane or something.
He does. We'll be doing iFly, so stay tuned for some video
on
that.
That's going to be a lot of fun. Ginger is here for Ask the Realtor, so if you have a question, you can go ahead and hit us up right now, 540-899-1015 or 800-685-1015. And let's go ahead and get right into this. So are people still wanting a separate or formal dining area in their homes? Because I know a lot of things, not a lot of things, but a lot of times these days, you want to eat on the couch. That's me. I don't know. I know a lot of families do that. They just go because they want to watch TV and whatnot.
Convenient.
So how do you feel about that? What's your opinion?
Well, I will say this time of year, it seems like people want more of that space to be able to have the big table.
Uh-huh.
But typically speaking, the open floor plan is still very much a thing.
Yeah.
So, that formal dining room is less and less popular in the floor plans that we're seeing. And even now, people, when they're renovating, are knocking walls down. So
okay.
I'd say more of that flex space where you can have the bigger table is really what people are looking for.
Cool. I like the open floor plan myself. That's just me. All right, so let's talk about decks. What if the home I'm selling doesn't have one? Is it going to help me sell one, or do I need to add one? What's the deal there?
So a couple things take into factor. Number one is time versus money, right? And also time of year. So right now, if you're going to sell a house, I've talked to three sellers in the last 2 weeks, no deck. They're not putting a deck on.
Okay.
Just price it appropriately for the fact that there's no deck. Because also right now it's going to be harder if they need concrete and footers and stuff like that with the cold.
Right.
So you might not even be able to put a deck on.
Okay.
So, just price it appropriately for not having the deck. And, it'll be an incentive for someone in the spring to go ahead and put the deck that they want on the house.
Right. Because, what if you do have a deck and they're not really a big fan, not really my style. Maybe they want a double decker or they wanted something different. So
bigger, smaller, steps down, no steps down. There's all different options. And then also the material. Composite is a lot more expensive, harder to get right now.
Right.
Lumber, price of lumber is still a little high.
Mm-hmm.
So it might cost you more right now to put a deck on anyway. So I'd say if you're going to sell, just sell it as it is.
Okay, cool. That composite's nice, by the way.
It's really
no
nice.
No splinters
That's
with
right.
composite. That's pretty
right.
cool. Ginger Walker is here with the Give Back team of Coldwell Banker Elite. Lauren's also here. Hi, Lauren. You can wave. I know you don't have a microphone. It's okay. So we're going to get right back to her in a minute. So get your text in, 540-899-1015 or 800-685-1015 if you have a question for Miss Ginger Walker. We'll be back with her momentarily. Yes, indeedy-do. Good morning. We've got Ginger Walker with the Give Back team of Coldwell Banker Elite in the house. Yes, indeed. Good morning. Everybody make some noise.
Woo!
Everybody! It's a party. That's what I'm talking about. I told him, I said, when y'all come in here, I like it. It's like a party. And I'm going to treat it as such.
I love it.
So thank you for being here as usual. And we've got the Ask the Realtor segment. So if you have a question, hit me up right now. Fletcher Construction Hotlines, 540-899-1015 or 800-685-1015. Ginger just recently found out that I'm not on TikTok and she doesn't
Jeremy, I am twice your age. I'm on the TikTok.
You don't look at those. That's
Well, thank you. Yeah. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. You're welcome. Maybe I'll get on TikTok just for you.
You need to get... Okay, so we're going to do a TikTok together.
Yeah, we're going to do the Walker Hayes dance, fancy like.
We're going to do it.
All right, we're going to do
it. Next time I'm here, after your show, we're going to do it.
All right, cool. I've got to learn it. All I know right now is the whipped cream on the top. I can just do my hands like that.
He's dancing,
cream.
Everyone.
Yep.
I know you can't see him, but he's actually
we'll
dancing.
We'll work it out.
Okay.
We'll do it. Right now, let's get a couple of these questions knocked out. So I know we discussed this last show about putting up holiday decor and how it affects, selling a house.
Yes.
Of course, at that time, it was Halloween decorations. Now
right.
we're transitioning into Christmas decorations.
Yep.
What does it add or take away when you're trying to sell a house?
So, it really depends. I mean, my recommendation is less is more. You have to live there. And if you want to enjoy the holidays, I'm not saying don't put it up, but just maybe don't go as crazy with some of it,
know,
because people want to see the house and they want to see the floor plan, the layout. The more distracting that the decorations are, the less likely that they're going to remember the floor plan or the amenities that the house actually has. So
when you say that, what comes to mind for me, just personally, would be to keep it more traditional and simple. Maybe some candles in the windows, some spotlights on the house, maybe.
Yeah.
Not something, not Clark Griswold.
Yeah, I was just going to say
100,000 twinkling little light bulbs might be a big distraction.
Well, and we have a client that wanted to list their house, and that's what they do. Like, they literally set the house to the music where you can, like, tune in on the radio station. Like, you know, that level. It's, like, double extra level. And we were like, you know, maybe you should wait or maybe scale back. And they didn't want to scale back. And you know what? They shouldn't have to. If they don't have to sell, if you don't have to sell, like, right now, you could wait. But if you need to sell right now, maybe, tone it down just a little.
So, in other words, you do you, boo-boo. Unless you need to sell right now, you might want to just bring it back a little bit.
And think of it this way. You got to pack all that stuff back up anyway because you're going to be moving.
That's
so
right.
The less you unpack, the less you have to pack.
It's a very good point.
There you go.
Very good point. Okay, so here's another question. Should you ask for new appliances, new carpet, new roof, or ask if an allowance is in the contract?
So that really depends. You know, a roof might be something that you might need to ask for.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, if it's going to impact the house or the insurance or things like that, if it's something that's going to continually damage, like it could cause problems, that's something you probably want to have addressed right away.
Okay.
But the caveat being that right now it's hard to get contractors. So in the course of the timeline of a contract, which is usually about 30 days, you may have to take a credit or have the, you know, the service paid for at closing, and then you have to bring that, you know, that person in to actually do the work. For the carpet, the paint, those sorts of things, it's, you know, maybe just take it off the price when you're actually making the offer as opposed to asking for a credit.
Okay, so that kind of brings me to another question that I have in my mind, actually. If you're going to, like, fix up or renovate one room and just get new appliances, new whatever, what room should that be?
Kitchen. Absolutely.
Okay. That's what I thought you were going to say. Why is that?
Well, first of all, the only problem with the kitchen is getting the appliances, because as most of you know, that's not always as easy as said, because of, you know, shortage of appliances right now. So make sure that you get things that match. They don't have to be the same brand, but just the same color or finish. But the kitchen is, like, you know, it's the heart of the home. So, and that's where people gather. So the kitchen, the primary bathroom, and the primary bedroom are definitely the three rooms that if you're going to do anything with, I'd start with the kitchen first.
I love it so much. So if you're going to renovate, do the kitchen.
Do the kitchen.
And if you're going to do Christmas decorations and you're trying to sell,
do them lightly.
Do them lightly. Scale back a little bit. Bring it back a notch. And don't do the total Clark Griswold thing.
No. Although I love that.
It's like, beautiful, isn't it?
I'm the one that drives around and looks for all that
stuff. Yes, me too. Maybe we'll do that too after we learn our TikTok dance.
Sounds good.
Ginger Walker is here with the Give Back team of Coldwell Banker Elite, along with the Gray Show. Appreciate you hanging out. We're about to get down and dirty. Down and dirty with Bring Your B Game. $50 in downtown Fredericksburg gift cards up for grabs. Ginger Walker with the Give Back team of Coldwell Banker Elite is here. She's going to be playing along with us, along with Lauren. Hi, Lauren.
Hi, Jeremy.
Hi. Hi, Jeremy.
Hi, Jeremy.
Those eyes she just gave me, I can't even tell you. All right, so Ginger, you have a special little announcement, don't you?
I do, actually.
Hit us with it real quick.
So, it's starting next year, we are going to be doing something that's going to impact 36 charities in the Northern Virginia, Quantico, Pentagon area. And we are very excited, so stay tuned. I'm actually going to give more details in December. But if you have a charity that's near and dear to your heart, I want you to actually get ready to start sending us that information. Not yet, because they might be one of the 36 charities that's going to be involved in a special donation back to them. So stay tuned for
that. I'd love to hear it. That's incredible. 36 charities.
36.
And you are the Give Back team after all.
Yes.
Love it. Love to see it.
Thank
love
you.
To hear it. Thanks
Thank
for
you.
Being here. And
so thanks for joining this episode of the Ask the Realtor segment at B101.5. If you have additional questions that we didn't answer today, make sure you drop a comment below. Happy to answer them the next time I'm at B101.5. Come say goodbye.
Goodbye.